Greetings, graduates, and congratulations on this momentous day. 30 years ago, I was where you are now, graduating from the University of Toronto, University College, with a Bachelor's of Science degree. A lot has happened in the last 30 years. Let's think about some of the big things. You were born. Smartphones were invented. Streaming TV, where we can binge watch entire seasons at one time. Maybe you'll be doing that after the ceremony. The emergence of artificial intelligence and natural language processing. How many of you have used ChatGPT in your homework this semester? You can admit it now, because you're done. Well, how many of you think I used ChatGPT for part of the speech? Well, you'll have to wait and see. But amidst all these incredible new discoveries in the last 30 years, my favorite one is discovery of exoplanets. So I want all of you to go out tonight and look at the night sky, or the next time it's clear, and look at the stars, because every star is a sun. And if our sun has planets, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, etc., it makes sense that other stars have planets also, and they do. And we astronomers have found thousands of planets orbiting other stars. So if you think about like Star Wars or Star Trek, we're not there yet. We're taking those first baby steps of understanding what's out there. There are hundreds of billions of stars in our galaxy alone, and it appears that every star has planets. That means there are trillions of possibilities out there for other worlds. So every society in history has had astronomy as part of our culture, and today's astronomy, we're trying to answer these ancient questions. How did we come to be? How did our galaxy, our sun, our Earth form and evolve? And are we alone in the universe? Well, we're all on some kind of journey, and let me share with you some of my early personal journey. I grew up right near here, just a few blocks away in the South Annex. At the time, on Brunswick Avenue, south of Harvard. At the time, it was a bit for the down and out, but I understand it's all gentrified now. And I used to walk to my high school, which just happened to be Jarvis Collegiate Institute, like a STEM school. And I walked across the campus, and one day, I saw signs for an open house at the University of Toronto for the astronomy department, which I always had a kind of interest in. So that Saturday, I walked to the, I'm not sure how all of you, you know, went to the open house or came to be at the school, but I went to the open house for the astronomy department, going to McLennan Physical Lab. That's somewhat of a tall building, going in the elevator up to the 14th floor. I stepped out, and there were professors and students and pamphlets. And immediately, wow, I can be an astronomer for a job? This is like one of the top 10 days of my life for sure. So I rushed home to tell my dad, and my parents being divorced, he lived out in Markham, Ontario. So that's far, you've got to take the subway to Finch, and then you take like a bus for a really long time. I was so excited to tell him, and I was shocked with his stern reaction of caution. He said, "Sara, you must get a job and support yourself." And he ended it with, "and not rely on any man." And I'm a parent too now. I see a lot of parents here. That's what we want. We want our kids to go out into the world and support themselves and be self-sufficient. But even though my dad didn't want me to be an astronomer, you know, I entered the university with studying pre-med to be the doctor he wished for, but I somehow knew at that early age that I'd found something that I love doing that I'm also very good at. And I hope all the parents are with me today and wishing that for you, to find something you love doing that you're also good at and pursue it. Well, I did become an astronomer, and I want to share with you two of my challenges, the two big challenges I had to overcome. The first big challenge was I had to go against my dad and my grandfather, and against my beloved dad was hard because I really did take everything he said seriously. And it's never easy to go against the expectations of our communities, be it your families or friends. But I do know that the university has equipped you with all the skills you need to chart your own course. And I just want you to keep that in mind, because now you're a graduate and you're going to go out into the world. And sometimes it's really hard to like stick to that inner voice, and you know what's best for you, and going sometimes against the wishes of your friends and family. But I implore you to trust your inner voice and to go along that path where you can find what will lead you to your true fulfillment. So let me tell you about my second big challenge, which happened a few years after I graduated from here. So to become an astronomer or a scientist, you go on to graduate school, just like you have medical school to become a doctor or law school to become a lawyer. So I moved away from here, left my home, and I went to Harvard to become to study astronomy. Well, at that time is when the first exoplanets were first discovered. And this was amazing because literally for thousands of years, people had been wondering about what is beyond Earth. Are there planets around other stars? And people first started finding those. But the big challenge was that most people didn't believe the exoplanets were real. The problem is that those stars, those other suns, they are so bright. They're big, they're massive, and any planet is so close to them, it's nearly impossible to find. And so tiny signals are hard to find and believe, and people never didn't think they were real. There was a lot of pushback. In science, we're naturally skeptical, and people thought this field would never go anywhere. Because remember, we only had science fiction movies like Star Trek and Star Wars, and in sort of like this weird twist on fate, it turns out, despite having thousands of planets we know about, our solar system is incredibly rare. We don't have any solar system copies. We have so many bizarre systems, like a Jupiter where an Earth should be, or Earths so close to the star, their surfaces are hot enough to melt rock. So the challenge was that people didn't believe they were real, but I'd set out to make this my life's path. And don't you hate it, or maybe you love it, when people say, this isn't going to work, you shouldn't do that, or you have the wrong set of friends? Sometimes it makes you just want to push back and really succeed. And that's what happened, and as I stand here today, it's with immense pride and satisfaction, looking back, using all the skills, the physics I learned here, my sort of slow learning of how to interact with other people, and all those skills taking me to be able to do my job, and in the end, helping to invent this entire new field of science, exoplanets, and the search for life beyond Earth. By the way, we don't have time to get into like the long lecture here. We're not looking for little green humanoids. We all want to meet an alien. We're just looking at planets. We're studying atmospheres of planets far away with our new James Webb Space Telescope. And we have the first capability in human history to find signs of life very obliquely by way of gases in the atmosphere, gases that don't belong in context with their environment that might be signs of life. So a new frontier of exploration beckons. As I stand before you today reminiscing about my own journey, I congratulate you on your accomplishments of reaching here today. What I love about me graduating 30 years ago and you're here today is our paths have intertwined at this pivotal moment when you're about to begin your own journey beyond these walls. Remember, the road to success is seldom a straight line. It will twist and turn, presenting obstacles. I just gave you those two brief examples. But I urge you to find something that you love doing that you're also good at, and to trust in your inner voice, something, a skill to hone, because it holds the power to guide you to your true purpose. I hope you can reflect over the years of all the lessons you've learned here. You know, not just all those, the problem sets and the textbooks and the lectures, but the skills and also just your friends and the things that you learned outside of class. I hope you will build courage to challenge the status quo and think beyond conventional boundaries. So in the grand scheme of things, we're just tiny specks in the vastness of the universe. And as we astronomers search for distant planets and signs of life, with all those stars in the night sky and in our galaxy, I hope it will remind you of infinite possibilities that lie before us. Just as every star has the potential to harbor a planet, each one of you has unleashed potential, just waiting to be tapped. Class of 2023, I have faith in your ability to shape the future. The torch is passed to you, and it's your turn to carry it forward. As you venture forth, may you find fulfillment in the pursuit of knowledge, may you embrace the wonders of discovery, and may you always believe in yourself and in the transformative power of your own potential. Congratulations, graduates. I wish you clear thoughts, clear skies, and your own incredible journey forward. Thank you.